good for like that.
LA is sitting really good on the solo.
Of the energy here.
On one thing.
I was born and raised here in LA County, and for my 25 years of living, I have never lived outside of this vicinity of LA County or LA City proper. I never have even thought about leaving. LA County and LA City is so specific and has such a special culture to it that I feel like most other people don't understand.
Windows down, with people that you love, listening to music that you love. It makes me feel like I am outside of LA, outside of like the city, and get like a little bit of stillness. That's what I find the most inspiring about driving in LA.
Ventura Freeway is cool. I like sitting traffic if I'm on Ventura. The wind blow my hair on my face.
A bubble of fabulousness. And then just driving solo. And also when you're on the highway and you're in your car, someone else is in their car, and you're kind of just looking at each other.
Just feeling the energy of the city, I feel like it just makes you feel so good. I grew up in LA, so I'm very used to this lifestyle. I used to be way more LA girl, hot girl shit type of energy here. I just did all of that, and I think it's very big now, and people come to LA sometimes for the wrong reasons, and they come here to want fame and to just be noticed and make money and all these things, which is all totally fine. There's, again, times in my life where I lean into more of my vices, and then there's times that I'm way more on top of my stuff and I feel more inspired and ready to go.
Just how much more aware of your body you are. And LA is good for that. LA is really good on making you very self-conscious about like where your move, like where your hands are, where your legs are, like how you look and everything. I think that's like, it's kind of dark, but that's something that LA reminds me of.
I like to picture a really long, tall shadow of yourself. The palm trees are freakishly tall here.
It's a sparkly feeling. I like looking at all the houses and the diamonds on the ocean. Life is sort of about doing what you want.
Doing what you want. Being present where you are.
Yeah.
Just liking what you're doing. Mm-hmm. Just then and there.
You gotta be here, baby.
Letting the people you love know you love them.
Mm-hmm.
I'm serious.
I know.
Is love worth it? It doesn't always feel like it, but yeah. I think love equals happiness equals so many things. It's just not this one dimensional thing of a monogamous relationship. It could mean, you know, self-love, love for family, love for the world. So it's important, and I don't think you can be human without love.
What to play when you're feeling in love?
Ooh. Like old, like Frank Sinatra music.
Or like, you're just too good to
yes,
me. Can't keep my eyes off of you.
Yep, that's the one.
That's a vibe. Or like Sade. Honestly, even by your side, always.
True.
You think I'm Sade?
The inspired state for me is usually a quick, it comes on quickly, and it kind of just like comes over me, and I'm really intent on one thing or piece of movement, and it almost feels like in that moment that's the only thing that exists.
I think an inspired state is just a state of flow, because nothing is really interrupting you. You're putting out energy that you're receiving.
I'm really inspired by the colors blue and green. I just love like green grass, like California in the spring, the rolling green hills and blue skies and fluffy white clouds. That's like my favorite. I am so happy whenever I can see that.
I like to incorporate like color theory. Like, I don't know, I love color. Like, I all my outfits, like whether it's with an accessory, a purse, or like my shoes, like I will always incorporate like a cute like pop color. And then secondly, I always make sure that it's comfortable. Like, that for me is like one of the biggest things.
Glamour is different for everyone. I think that glamour to me means opulence, and confidence is a big one, and just owning who you are and your own perception of beauty, owning that and not letting anyone tell you what you are, what you aren't, and just existing and being as you are. And I think that's glamour in itself.
So much of my art is about introspection and self-reflection on my part, but you can tell so much about a situation or character or story just based on what the environment looks like, you know, the way you draw something, what kind of doors are there, what kind of things the character would have on their sink countertop in their bathroom, or what would they have on their walls? Would they have stacks of clutter in their room or clothes on the floor? You know, it's like a really good way to describe someone, and it's like something that I've seen so much in my own life, because I'm always at home, always in my room, you know. Especially now.
We have a lot of free time these days, so a lot of time to just sit with myself. But I think the biggest thing that's been on my mind is just relationships in general. Just thinking about, I don't know, how much value there is in all of the relationships we have within our lives, of all kinds.
In a very transitional phase in life, and I also feel like that's what's going on like in the universe as well, and just like in the current affairs of this country, you know, with COVID, with the presidency, with everything. And I'm really just interested in what's gonna come next, like what's, you know, the next crossroad or the next transition moment to like reach us to, you know, this new state that we'll all be in, it like kind of like a new state of consciousness. So I'm very curious about that. And just like on a personal level, like so much has happened this year. So I am keeping just a sense of curiosity and wonder about what 2021 will bring, what prosperity it will bring, what pain it will bring, what happiness it will bring, and just being open to that.
Like a Laffy Taffy? No, like Jolly Rancher. Like a grape Jolly Rancher, I feel like.
I don't know what kind of grape that is, but like, what in the even?